गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑफ क्लास 4 मैथ्स। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 2 एंड चैप्टर नंबर 3 रिवीजन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फर्स्टली वी विल सी ब्रीफली द चैप्टर नंबर 2 लॉन्ग एंड शॉर्ट एंड आई विल गिव यू सम आइडिया ऑफ हाउ क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम द चैप्टर नंबर 2 लॉन्ग एंड शॉर्ट। सो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द वी विल स्किप द स्टोरी बिकॉज द स्टोरी कांट बी आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम। यस, दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड इन इंटर स्कूल स्पोर्ट मीट। दिस इज 100 meter रेस फॉर द गर्ल्स। अरुंधति इज नियरेस्ट द फिनिशिंग लाइन। She is about 6 meters from it. Behind her is Rehana. Konkana and Uma are running behind Rehana. Look at the picture. To answer the question below, choose from these distances. So, the first question is, how far is Rehana from Arundhati? So, what we have to find? We have to find this distance. So, we can clearly see that the distance of this from and this, this one is smaller. So, obviously, the distance will be less than 6 meter. So, only one option is there, which is less than 6 meter, that is 3 meters. Similarly, B, how far ahead is Rehana from Konkana and Uma? So, you can see this, the distance between the Arundhati and the finishing line is approximately equal to this distance. So, the answer will be 6 meter. Similarly, you can solve C question. How far are Konkana and Uma from the finishing line? So, we have to give the distance from this to this. Right? So, this is about 6 meter, this is 3, which is equal to 9. 9 plus 6 equals to 15. Okay. This type of question can be asked. In a 1500 meter race, people run dash kilometer. Okay. So, you have to convert 1500 meters into the kilometer. So, we know that 1500 meters equal to 1.5 kilometer. Now, converting 3000 meter into kilometer, what we are doing? Just divide it by 1000, right? So, we have given a shortcut method of dividing the 1000 number by this type of scenario. So, cutting the zeros, right? And you will get the answer 3. Now, have you heard about a marathon race in which people have run about 40 kilometers? People run marathon on road because the track of stadium is only 40 meters. So, now what is asked? 10 round of stadium track equals to dash kilometers. So, firstly, we will multiply 400 into 10 for making it 10 rounds. So, you will get 4000 meter, right? When you will multiply 400 meters into 10, you will get 4000 meters. And converting that meter into kilometer, we need to divide it by 1000. So, when you divide 4000 divided by 1000, you will get 4 kilometers. So, if you run a marathon on a stadium track, you will have to complete dash round. So, this you can do by your own self for a marathon 40 kilometers. And approx 10 round, we ran 4 kilometers. So, how much you will get the answer? See in your PDF file or the notebook. moving further. Yes, running exercise type of question can also be asked in the MCQs. The doctor has told Devi Prasad to run 2 km every day to stay fit. He took one round of the field. How far did he run? So, he ran through the boundaries of the field, right? He completed one round. So, we have to calculate total running distance. So, 500 plus 500, which is equal to 1000. 1000 plus 500, 1500, 1500 plus 500, which is equal to 2000 meters. And dividing 2000 meters by 1000, we will get 2 kilometers. Okay, for converting meters into kilometers, we usually divide it by 1000. And when we will divide 2000 by 1000, we will get 2 kilometers. The field was very far from his home. So, he chose a park nearby. The boundary of the park was about 400 meters long. How many rounds of the park must Devi Prasad run to complete 2 km? So, this type of question can also be asked. You can see the answer and the method in the PDF file also. Yes, this type of question can be asked. This is of from this distance, Kozhikode is of about 24, and from this point, Thalasseri is of about 46 km. So, what you have to find? You have to find the distance between the Kozhikode and Thalasseri. So, you have to just simply add it up the distance, 24 plus 46. Okay, this type of question can be asked from the chapter number 2. You will be given some meters, you have to convert it into kilometers. You have to find some distance, total travel distance. Okay, that type of question can be asked. Moving further to chapter number 3. Chapter number 3 is a trip to Bhopal. In this, we have covered the whole story in detail. So, let's see what can be asked in the unit test and let's revise it quickly. So, firstly, in this scenario, number of children were given. We have to find the total. So, you can just add it up and get the answer. Okay, you will get 210 students. Do we need 4 buses? One bus can take 50 children. 4 bus can take 50 into 4. So, 50 into 4 equals to 4, 5 is 20. So, 200 students can be accommodated in the 4 buses. So, there are a total of dash children going. How many? 210. If they get 4 buses, how many children will get seats? So, we have calculated in 4 buses, 200 can be occupied. So, 200 children can get seats. Will there be any children left without seats? Yes, the total is of 210 and buses can accommodate 200. So, the difference between the 210 and 200 is 10. So, 10 children will be left without seats. This is the story which we have covered. So, no need of revision in that. Each minibus can take 35 students. How many buses are needed? So, you have to just simply divide it. Okay. Now, here we have seen something revolve around timing. For example, they have started the trip at 9 o'clock. Okay. So, they reached, if they don't stop anywhere, we should reach there in 2 hours. That is around dash o'clock. So, first is 9 o'clock and they will reach after 2 hours, which is equal to 11 o'clock, right? So, this type of question can be asked. Now, moving further, this is all about general knowledge and story. Okay, yes, this type of question, this type of scenario can be given and you can be asked to give the answer. For example, here it is given. Each bus takes about 15 minutes to refill and there are two buses to be refilled. So, they stop there about for about dash minutes. So, there are two buses and each bus take 15 minutes to be refilled. So, for two buses, how much time it is needed? So, we will multiply 15 into 2, which is equals to 30 minutes, right? So, in this number change can be possible, okay? In the exam, the question can be like this. Each bus can take about 20 minutes and there are total 3 buses. So, what you will do? You will just simply multiply 20 into 3, which is equal to 60 minutes, right? This is the whole story. Okay. Yes. This lunch type scenario can also be asked because in this a calculative and a interesting scenario is there. The children are hungry by this time. So they take out their lunch packs. Biscuits, orange and bananas are also distributed in all the buses. Each child is to be given one orange, one banana and 5 biscuits. All children take oranges and biscuits, but 38 children do not take bananas. So there are total 210, right? We know that there are total 210 children. So giving one orange to each, how many orange we will need? 210, right? Now giving 5 biscuits to each of the student. So how many biscuit we will need? 210 multiply by 5, right? So you will get 1050 biscuits. Okay, you will need 1050 biscuit for the whole student. Now banana, coming to the banana, one banana is given to each student. So, in total, we need 210, but 38 children do not take the banana. So, for the answer of the banana given to the student, we have to subtract 38 from the 210. And whatever answer will you get, that will be your final answer. Now, moving further, these puzzles question are very interesting and can be asked in the exam also. We have seen in detail all the puzzle. For example, this C1, a number becomes double if it is increased by 8. So, see, for example, we assume that number is X. Then, it becomes double if it is increased by X. So the equation form will be like this, right? So this X will go this side and sign will change. So X equals to 8. This type of puzzles. This is the story which can be also asked. Okay, you will be given the boat, ticket price and trip time. So, confusing and a tricky question can be asked in the exam. All the question will be from the textbook only. No question will be asked outside of the textbook. Right? This type of question can be asked. Which pair of numbers add to make more than 500? So, in this what you have to do? You have to simply add it up all the number and see which makes a pair of more than 500. Okay. So, here we end our lecture. All the best for your unit test exam.